Hello everyone, this is Manoj, English coach. Welcome to Love English, and in today's video I'm gonna be reading a story called The Real Jewels. Now let's get started. The district of South Kannada in Karnataka is very different from any other. The literacy rate here is high, people are enterprising and hardworking. They have traveled all over the world in search of employment. If you see any Udupi vegetarian restaurant in India or any part of the globe, it is sure to have been started by a person from South Kannada. The Infosys Foundation has a project called A Library for Every School. In this, we donate books mainly to government school libraries so that children have easy access to a variety of books. For this, I travel extensively in rural areas and donate books written in Kannada on various subjects. All the traveling has helped me to understand what children want to read in different places. During my travels, I frequently stay in the houses of people I meet, as often there are no hotels in the small towns and villages I visit. Most of the time, I stay with the family of a teacher from the school I'm visiting. Sometimes I stay with people I had never met earlier. In India, a guest is always treated with a lot of love, affection and respect. An old Sanskrit saying is Atithi Devo Bhava, meaning God comes in the form of a guest. I have felt this to be so true, especially during my stay in villages. The poorest of the poor have treated me with so much love and affection. They have given me the best hospitality possible without knowing who I am or expecting anything in return. In 1998, I went to a village in South Kannada for a school function. It was a rainy season and the small village was on the coast of Arabian Sea. It was pouring and there were no hotels in the village. The school teacher was a bachelor and lived in a rented room. He told me, "Madam, the chairman of this school is a fine gentleman. He has asked me to tell you that you could stay tonight with his family. You cannot travel today because of this rain. Even the bridge has gone underwater." I did not have much option. I felt a little uncomfortable staying with someone I had never even met. By that time, the chairman, Mr. Athappa, came with an umbrella to call me. He had been caught up in some important work and not been able to attend the function. His house was huge. It was functional without much decoration. There was a big granary room and a storage place for coconuts and vegetables. It had red oxide flooring and was like many traditional houses of South Kannada, where there was an inside courtyard. Water had to be drawn from a well at the side of the kitchen. There were a few bedrooms on the ground floor and the first floor. There was a cow shed at the back along with a large vegetable garden. That was all I could see as it was already dark and the raindrops were hitting me like pebbles hard on my feet. As soon as I entered, the lady of the house came with a warm smile and towels to wipe myself. Her smile put me instantly at ease. Without much ceremony, she said, "Please feel comfortable. Dinner will be ready in half an hour." I changed my dress and came to the dining hall. In the huge hall, there were only four people, including me, the couple and their elderly mother. Plantain leaves were laid on the floor and the cook was serving. There were innumerable food items and I did not know where to start. The old lady of the house was very gracious. She reminded me of my large-hearted grandmother. After dinner, I wanted to chat with her. When I told her, she said, "If you want, you can stay in my room so that we can talk." I preferred that rather than staying all alone in the first floor guest room. I have always wondered why people in South Kannada are so much more educated compared to any other district of Karnataka. I asked Kutamma, "Did you study when you were young?" Kutama sighed as if she was in pain. "No, unfortunately, I did not go to school. When I was young, we were extremely poor, and I was a coolie in the garden of a school teacher. I always felt education is essential. If you can read and write, you can secure a better job. In my case, it was not possible. So I was determined that my only son, Athappa, should study as much as he could, and I would work hard for that. My husband also felt the same way, but he was killed by a snake bite when my son was only 5 years old. It was my promise to him that I would educate my son. I tried to imagine life 6 decades back, the social pressures, the great poverty, and no help from the government. I have met many women of that age group who have told me more or less the same story. Kutama continued, my son did not disappoint me. He went to Bombay as a hotel boy. He cleaned the plates in the morning and in the evenings, went to Mohavira Night School and studied there. Yes, I know this school. It is in Worli and it's the oldest Kannada school in Bombay. Many children have studied there. Once he finished his schooling, he became a clerk at the counter of a hotel and went to night college. He got his degree and started his own hotel in Bombay. He became very successful. Then why is he here now? Kutama smiled. I could see she was proud. He started many hotels in Bombay, but I remained in my village. I never felt comfortable in Bombay in spite of all the money he had, because nobody spoke my language there, and I love this village. Yes, I know, there's a saying in Sanskrit, Janani Janmabhumischa Swargdapi Gariyasa. It means your motherland is always a heaven. You are a learned lady, so you can recite all this in Sanskrit, but my intuition told me to stay here and do something for our own people. My son became very wealthy and handed over his business to his son. He is now 65 years old, and 10 years back he returned to his village. How does he spend his time? I could understand the old lady not wanting to move out of her home, but I was unable to understand how a busy, successful person like Athappa could retire to this God-forsaken sleepy village. When he became rich, my son asked me, Amma, I've earned so much wealth. I want to know what you want. I remember you sold all your jewelry for my fees in college. You had only one meal so that I could have two. Now I want to buy lots of jewelry for you. What did you answer? I told my son that in life, the real jewelry is education. The school teacher for whom I worked when I was young used to tell everything will perish over a period of time. Flowers, beauty, food, no person looks beautiful forever. But education brings confidence to your face, and that is a real beauty. I've crossed the age to wear jewelry. If you respect my wishes, build as many free schools as possible in as many villages in South Kendra. My son understood my feelings. He himself shifted to this village and has till today built 10 such schools. He remains very busy managing these schools. Now I understood the reason behind the high literacy rate of the area. Women like Kutama had not studied, but they had understood the importance of good education. They had insisted their children go to school. It is certainly true that if one man studies, only one person is educated. Whereas, if one lady studies, the entire family is educated.
Thank you for attending this session. Do share and subscribe to this channel for more lessons like this. Check out other video lessons by clicking on the video.